Kiss on the hand may be quite continental, but
nije uzalud Marilyn Monroe uvijek tvrdila, pa čak i otpjevala da su dijamanti ženini najbolji prijatelji. Kao što je u njezino doba Merlinka bila mjerna jedinica za seksipil, tako je danas asocijacija za najluksuzniji i najglamurozniji nakit tvrtka Chopard. S tradicijom od gotovo 150 godina ovaj skupocijeni brend glavni je opskrbljivač svakog crvenog tepika. A svo to blještavilo koje gledate na koži zvijezda, dizajn je ruku kćerke vlasnika Chopara, Caroline.
We have very design pieces, very extravagant, to the really, really the top rock, which yeah. I would say is the 85 carat DIF Golconda, and the value is around $20 million.
Is it easy to find a customer for that?
Well, kind this is a collector's item. It's like a piece of art. It's like a painting from Picasso or Van Gogh. It's really not, and there's one of a kind in the world.
Iako je Chopard već desetljećima najvažniji luksuzni dodatak svim celebritima, najveći proboj tog brenda među svjetski jet set dogodio se u Kanu.
12 years ago, Caroline Gauss, the Schäufele, the co-president of the company, met the president of the film festival and they got in touch with the other, were talking and discussing, and suddenly they decided that Caroline should design the Palm d'Or, the Golden Palm for the festival, which is given every year to the actors, and that's what happened.
Suradnja s poznatim zvijezdama tvrtki Chopard donijela je dodatnu reklamu, a samim zvijezdama neprocjenjiv status. Naime, nema svatko čas da se ukrasi s nekoliko milijuna.
How do you choose celebrities that you are going to work with them?
I think they have to have personality, character, and they have to love the brand.
Is it important, a good image?
I think it's good that they have a good image, a good background, a good reputation. Not to say a clean family life, but yes, I think it's better for the image.
Naime, opće je poznato kada je riječ o vrhunskoj kvaliteti i ekskluzivnom imenu da se iznimno pazi na ljude koje se povezuju uz brand. Tako je primjerice prošle godine starleta Jordan izbačena s Cartierova polo eventa zbog njenog lošeg imidža.
We are always polite, of course, and everybody who knocks on the door will have an open door, but we cannot do everything. So yes, you have to be selective. But this is not a big problem for us.
This collection for this year's red carpet, approximately how much one piece costs?
Well, the prices go from starting off from 40,000 euro, going to 500,000 euro, to 1.4 million. And as far as I remember, the biggest piece I've seen is around 2.5 million and up.
Kada pogledate blještavilo gotovo svakog crvenog tepiha i zvijezde koje na sebi imaju Choparov nakit u vrijednosti od nekoliko desetaka miliona dolara, sigurno se često puta pitate zašto je sve to toliko skupo. Upravo smo zato otišli do Choparove tvornice u Ženevi kako bi ekskluzivno mogli sudjelovati u procesu izrade jedne luksuzne ogrlice ili primjerice sata.
Here our owners, the family Schäufele, is coming every day here to our headquarter. And all the staff members are very close. I mean, they see the family, the managers. I mean, they have the chance to talk directly. It's a very transparent way of communication. And we control 100% the quality. This is the point. I mean, Chopard is much, much quality minded. History, tradition, at the same time, innovation, new design.
Uz najnovija i najnaprednija tehnološka čuda, ono što je karakteristično u proizvodnji Chopara je da sami proizvode vlastito zlato kao i dijelove za satove. Stoga i ne čudi što pojedini komadi dosežu basnoslovne cijene.
We train, you know, goldsmiths and watchmakers, and we send them to New York and to Japan and to Singapore. So if you're living in Singapore and you buy an expensive watch, I mean, you really have the right to get the a good after-sales service. You know, this is something you don't see, you don't talk about it really in your marketing campaign or publicity. This is something very important.
A sada pogledajte jednu mini radionicu kako nastaje vrhunsko zlato, odnosno nakit i satove. Sve počinje s ubacivanjem krutog zlata u kotao.
This is now the final cake, let's put it. 4 kilos, and now 18 karat rose gold. Per year, we are producing about 6 tons of gold. And this piece now is traveling to the next workshop, to the stamping workshop. And this is really, you know, the place where all the parts get stamped. And once the piece of design is validated, yes, we have to create the tools to do the parts.
How much it makes time to create one tool?
It's about 30 hours. 40 hours. It's really very intensive.
And
it costs money. I mean, this is a fortune.
Ulazim u radionicu najskupljeg nakita na svijetu. Sada ćemo vidjeti kako se radi.
Very often Karen has a very precise idea, or she gets a special stone, and she's imagining, well, this could be perfect.
Just a little view of all treasure. Mm-hmm. Beautiful yellow diamond. His name is the son of Africa. It's 150 carats. Another earrings with a yellow diamond pear shape.
How many hours approximately takes to produce?
1,000.
Ovo je samo dio luksuzne Choparove kolekcije koja je bila napravljena ekskluzivno za ovogodišnji crveni tepih Kanskog filmskog festivala. Vrijednost sa 62 komada nakida je negdje preko 500 miliona eura. Ove naušnice primjerice nosila Eva Hercigova, dok je ove luksuzne naušnice na svojim ušima imala Penelope Cruz. Nosim kano, Chopard je sponsor većine festivala te dizajnira mnoge prestižne nagrade. No također postoji jedna posebna ljubav među glumicama, Choparom i Oscarom.
They say, well, if I have a piece of jewelry of Chopard, this is good luck and this makes us winning the Oscars. So it was incredible. I mean, Charlize Theron, Hilary Swank, Rachel Weisz, they were all wearing Chopard. Have a mirror. The lucky jeweler, exactly.
Is somebody offended, for example, if one actress has a bigger and one smaller rock of the jewelry?
Not as far as I know. I've never seen that before, that somebody said, oh, you got the bigger one. I think everybody chooses the piece she or he personally likes, and it fits to the personality, fits to the dress.
Did it ever happen that somebody stole the jewelry when it was rented?
Not as far as I know, no. Not at least not in my area under my control. That never happened so far.
No, iako je pravilo da što si slavniji i bogatiji manje trošiš jer ti je gotovo sve besplatno, ipak nitko nije toliko darežljiv da zvijezdi daruje ogrlicu od nekoliko miliona. No zato dobije besplatno tjelohranitelja.
Of course we have to make an insurance on the pieces we borrow for one evening, and if we exceed a certain amount of money, we will put a bodyguard on your side and he will protect, first of all, he will protect you, and second, he will protect the piece of jewelry.
If they want to buy a piece, and a lot of them do, then we give them an ambassador treatment, so they get a family prize.
Jedan od prvih Choparovih manekenki bila je Carla Bruni, a zanimljivo je da je nakon njezine udaje za Sarkozija Chopard morao ponoviti cijelu kolekciju satova koju je ona reklamirala zbog velikog interesa kupaca. Danas je njezino ambasadorsko mjesto zamijenila Eva Hercigova.
She is the face, and she is very can make very different looks, you know. She can be the blonde, the dark, the very classical and a little bit the more vampire type, so she's very, very variable, and that's the reason why we choose her, and she's a wonderful lady too.
Ono što je nakit za žene, to su satovi za muškarce. Tim je povodom i sam Elton John potpisao jednu kolekciju satova za Chopard, budući je njegov ambasador već dugi niz godina. No ljubav je obostrana, pa je tako Chopard partner Eltonove udruge koja se bori protiv side, a koja je kroz godine svog rada uspjela već skupiti preko 120 miliona dolara.
He gave me his input and I did the job because it's my job. He knows how to do the music, but he's a great watch collector. He loves watches, so he has his very precise taste, and we were discussing how the watch should be.
Ova mašinerija neprocjenjive vrijednosti nije podbacila ni u vrijeme ekonomske krize, pa tako Chopard sljedeće godine slavi svojih 150 godina rada. A budući da se ovaj luksuzni nakit od nedavno može naći u Lijepoj našoj, možda će uskoro svo ovo blještavilo krasiti ljepotu naših celebritija. Jedna je balkanska diva i onako nedavno otpjevala da su samo dijamanti vječni i čisti te nikada ne lažu žene.